The U.S. Air Force has taken a major step when it comes to AI or artificial intelligence-enabled unmanned flight. It's stated that it's conducted the first flight test of an initial version of the AI-driven computer brain, which is being developed under the Skyborg program. Skyborg is aimed at developing a family of low-cost drones that can be reused but are cheap enough so that losses in combat can be financially and operationally tolerated. For this test, the service used a Kratos UTAP-22 Mako unnamed aircraft. Viewers may note that the Skyborg project is supported by Kratos, Boeing and General Atomics, which are under contract to provide UAVs for this initiative. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how the Skyborg program could usher in a new era for the U.S. Air Force. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. The U.S. Air Force Life Cycle Management Center, AFL-CMC, at Wright-Patterson Air Force Base in Ohio, announced the successful completion of the flight test. As reported, the flight was conducted from Tyndall Air Force Base in Florida and lasted approximately 2 hours and 10 minutes. The focus was on the Skyborg Autonomy Core System, ACS. U.S. Air Force Brigadier General Dale White, the service's program executive officer for Skyborg, as well as for fighters and advanced aircraft, said in a statement, "We're extremely excited for the successful flight of an early version of the brain of the Skyborg system. It's the first step in a marathon of progressive growth for Skyborg technology. These initial flights kick off the experimentation campaign that will continue to mature the ACS and build trust in the system." Brigadier General Heather Pringle, the Skyborg Technology Executive Officer and head of AFRL, added, "Through this operational experimentation campaign, AFRL is leaning forward to get early engagement with the warfighter to deliver a suite of full mission autonomy in a relevant timeline. AFRL is proud to be developing this force multiplier for the U.S. Air Force with our partners at PEO Fighters and Advanced Aircraft and the 96th Test Wing. The main aim of this test was to validate if Skyborg ACS was able to safely control the UTAP-22 Mako and guide it to conduct few basic maneuvers within a defined area." Air defense systems have come a long way from their early humble origin. For example, let's take the Russian S-400. The powerful main radar of S-400, which has a range of 600 kilometers, is complemented by target acquisition radars like 67 N6 Gamma D and 9 N6 Prativnik G radars in L-band, Nebo SVU in the very high frequency band, and Nebo M and Zebu M in multiband. Some of these radars, like Nebo SVU and Zebu M, have been claimed to have the ability to detect even stealth aircraft like F-22 Raptor and F-35 Lightning II. In this situation, it's necessary to have systems that could be used to penetrate contested airspaces. Ideally, these should be unmanned and low cost so that they could be relatively easy to replace. AFL-CMC and the Air Force Research Laboratory, AFRL, are working together to manage the Skyborg program, which was publicly revealed in 2019. The 96th Test Wing, which has been assigned the role of lead test unit for the Skyborg program, is based at Eglin Air Force Base in Florida. While Kratos UTAP-22 Mako has been used for this test, one of the unmanned combat aerial vehicles, UCAV, that's been earmarked for future integration is the XQ-58A Valkyrie, also developed by Kratos. The U.S. Air Force completed the first ever test flight of stealthy XQ-58A Valkyrie in 2019. Valkyrie is conceptualized as part of the Loyal Wingman initiative, where it's supposed to fly alongside a manned aircraft and provide mission assistance. It's already in the framework of the Skyborg program as part of AFRL's low-cost attritable aircraft technology LCAT project. It has a max speed of around Mach 0.85. It can carry two small-diameter bombs or compact electronic warfare equipment or surveillance systems. It can take off from a short runway like a plane or can be launched into the air via rocket. Future variants could be developed for operation from an aircraft carrier. Valkyrie has two aspects that make it a unique platform. One, it has a long range of about 2,450 miles or 3,950 kilometers. Two, it's pretty cheap at only $2 to $3 million per piece. This means that each UCAV costs the same as a single Patriot missile, which is not reusable, and more than 30 of these can be bought for the price of an F-35, which costs around $90 million per aircraft. Initial success for the Skyborg program is a major boost for the U.S. Air Force. If the Skyborg program can successfully develop an AI brain that can manage the flight of UAVs like Valkyrie, it'll be a game changer. Valkyrie is compact in dimension and, being stealthy, it'll be hard to detect and track. This will make it difficult for air defense systems to engage it. Since it's low cost, it can be deployed in large numbers to saturate air defense systems. A swarm of Valkyrie or similar UCAVs deployed with different payloads, like some with electronic warfare equipment and some with guided bombs, will be a complex challenge for even the best air defense systems. Even if most are intercepted during a strike, some will get through and knock off an air defense fortification. In a battle scenario, it could be dedicatedly used to engage air defense while stealth fighters like F-35 and F-22 take on enemy fighters. This will greatly reduce American losses, making it feasible to take on Russian and Chinese air defense.